Menteri Bakni ya ketana PWD Roads Ubaderu hak juga por sembut menteri rangba kejela uba persun tinsong ulap pengsan bakejing ai menteri ya keserok dan kedahar construction company kalong namar bakadei kebana kejela Meghalaya bat tipru ya kakam menteri la ban kedo ka public works department kelasya kena wakala hak ban pendem hak ibriu badan hak bor ban ai ya kejing tri ban sna ya keserok light core pomlakrai light lingkon kebajrong Kerbau point 1.8 kilometer. Bat kebakot syaka life of glory syaka company. Kebadi try deki bahaya yang jok menteri ke serkar jela klam de burom syu yaki kendon. Ubat tensong lak kubur ba ka PWD kela a yaki work order syaka dahar company. Namar kedai ke belak itu ba hapok ke jela. Namar kelak teri buon kikam. Dan kebau lak penkesan ru ba ka PWD ke itu ba yaka company. Wala kampat penbiang. Makna yaki kot kisla nak bentar ketik projek. Ulang bagi ke company ke balak ban kot board hak jing dan kepisa menteri ya kekam. Itu bagi bapan menteri ya projek sena serong ke dan kembahan riu buat nyokun hon. Ke balak biang na dong sedong ke jing dan kam. Bat ke jing jit ya ke company ke long hapening ke jing mikmat jang barok ke company ya ke balak liat dan ke tender committee.
See, I really don't know what is that violating the norms. I really don't understand. What norms are they talking about? Because we have for that particular project, not less than 6 or 7 parties participated, okay? They qualified. Because pre-qualification was done, means the technical bid was open, and that also in presence of the authorized representative of each company or each contractor. Then evaluation was done. Then after everything was done, cleared by the tender committee in the technical bid, because we have two bid. One is technical bid and number two is financial bid. When they qualified in the technical bid, the next is to open the financial bid. So in the technical bid, all of them, they qualified. All of them qualified. So when I saw yesterday in the statement, I really don't know. I get confused. Even me also, I get confused. Why they allege, why allegation made that the PWD has flawed the regulation and norms of the government. In fact, no such flaws at all. Because as I said to you, the tender committee is constituted from all the departments. They were there. Maybe small issues here and there, which is not at all technically serious. So that is always considered. It is always considered. This is not the first time that we opening tender. This is not the only project that we open, but thousands and thousands of projects tender committee has to clear. Detecting it. So therefore, as far as this Lycor Pomlakrai Lailengkot Road is concerned, as I said to you, all of them they qualified. So technical bid was open. Then after the opening of technical bid, it was also uploaded in the website. Still people has the opportunity in case if the evaluation of documents is not in order, still people have the opportunity to raise objection. Okay, because after 2 days we fix for the financial bid. Okay, then we notified, okay, on such date financial bid will be open, tender committee will sit, then again fixed. Then again, authorized representative was invited. About 4 out of 6, I think about 4 of them, they attended. Again, nothing was there. Even the authorized representative were there of those contractors or company, whatever. So, on the basis of L1, so it was found out that Dhar Construction was considered for Arlet Man of War. Because the criteria is whoever whoever quoted lowest, we are bound, legally speaking, we are bound to consider for allotment of work. That is a small issue. That is a small issue. If you talk about the security, security visit, short of maybe 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs, 4 lakhs, even 10 lakhs, there's no harm. But what we have to do is from the demand, we have to recover that. We have to tell them, hey, you deposit. Before issuing the final work order, they have to enclose it. In fact, that criteria is not at all so important. The important point here is only the technical qualification, because that is more important than anything else. So once all of them qualified, not only that, but as I said to you, about 6 companies, they qualified in the technical qualification. So the second step is for financial bid, where we open, and ultimately we found out that the L1 happens to be the hard construction. That is very easy. See, from the PUD, we are the one who issue work order. Okay? To any contractor. In fact, that the information we already knew. Even without furnishing, even if the company, the hard company or anybody, because the hard company has been working here in Meghala, so we knew the commitment, we knew the financial capacity, we knew everything. In fact, that is secondary. As I said to you, because importantly is the qualification. Technical qualification is very important. If they don't qualify, means you cannot even open the financial bid. That's what I'm saying, that is a small issue. The small issue, and then ultimately they, because see, when you talk about the existing commitment, I think this party, they got confused. Why? Because when you ask about the existing commitment, they thought it is the World Bank project, because this is the first time of World Bank project. Otherwise, they don't have problem to furnish it about the existing commitment. And then even PUD ourselves, we knew what is the commitment of the Dhar company or any company who worked with the PUD department in Meghala, except those people who does not work in Meghala, because this is a national tender, it's different issue. But our own company, our own people who work in Meghala, whoever must be A, B, C, D, even if they don't furnish, we already knew it, the existing commitment.